Hi, I'm Corey, and welcome to the fourth episode of the standard What's in Your Box training series. Today's topic is variable valve timing, and we're going to talk about how it works and about the differences in the VVT components that you have available to you now. Variable valve timing, or VVT technology, is a complex system designed to reduce emissions, increase fuel mileage, and improve the performance overall, especially in these newer, smaller displacement engines. In real time, the VVT system will adjust the timing of the valves for optimum performance and fuel economy, depending on the conditions and, of course, the RPMs. Now, to operate correctly, VVT systems aren't just dependent on VVT components like the solenoids and the sprockets. And although those are important, these systems also require components like cam sensors to operate accurately, as the VVT system is going to be very dependent on real-time data. Now, the two primary components in the VVT system are the solenoids and the sprocket, which is also sometimes called a cam phaser. But because of their higher OE failure rates, we're going to spend most of our time talking about the solenoids. Now, when a solenoid fails, there are three types of solenoids that you could recommend: a lower cost aftermarket option, an OE, or really an OES, original equipment service part, or a precision engineered replacement solenoid from Standard and Blue Streak. Inside the lower cost aftermarket box, you're going to find a part where corners have definitely been cut. On this example, the internal shaft is plastic, meaning it can easily break or crack. There's also plastic on the oil screen, which over time can come apart and clog the screen. But probably the biggest downside in this solenoid is that there is no lubrication groove inside of the solenoid. Now, this can delay the response time of the solenoid and lead to a premature failure. Another option may be an original equipment part. But let's remember that the only reason someone needs a solenoid in the first place is because the original failed. And replacing it with the exact same part that failed doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. In many cases, though, OE service parts aren't actually OE parts at all and could be made in an entirely different place from where the OE part was originally made. Regardless, let's take a closer look at the OE part and see how it compares to the lower cost part. Now, they both use the same plastic oil screen, but the internal design is a little bit better. As you can see, there is a lubrication groove here. And instead of using plastic for the internal shaft, they use aluminum, which is better, but it can still deform over time and alter the valve timing. Now let's take a closer look at what's in our box. The first thing you're going to notice is that it has a welded steel oil screen, which is much stronger, and it won't break down and clog the valve. Inside, you'll also see a lubrication groove for performance and durability. The other big difference between ours and the OE design is the material used on the internal shaft. Instead of using a softer metal like aluminum, we use a high-strength steel, which won't flex and it won't lose its shape over time. So here's an easy way to explain that to your customers. OE set the bar, the competition doesn't meet it at all, we exceed it. In addition to the highest quality solenoids, we also have a complete line of VVT sprockets, oil control valves, VVT solenoid kits, which include both solenoids and VVT service kits for a complete repair. And because we are the VVT experts, we lead the industry with more than 600 part numbers. And that means you'll be able to find the correct VVT component regardless of what your customers are looking for. Precision engineering and manufacturing, improvements over the original design, testing and validation, and with the industry's best coverage, that's what's in our box. What's in yours?